Hello, Rick. Does this game tonight, jumping right into the game tonight, does it have the same feel as Wednesday night's game, and that you're trying to have a response game against a good team that you lost to in the prior game?
Yeah, for sure. You know, we did a lot of good things in the first game, but you know, the ending of the third quarter and the fourth quarter really hurt us, and so we've got to put together 48 minutes, and really the other thing we've got to really work to get a better start at both ends. You know, we're climbing out of a hole most of the first quarter, and then you know, we got a lead momentarily, and then you know, we gave up a 5-0 run at the end. So you know, every second of a game against a team with like Portland that's so precise and so skilled is really important.
Brad?
Yeah, Rick, I think after the Friday game and Kristaps' two offensive fouls, you said you were going to look at them on tape. And I'm specifically wondering, when a guy is 7'3" and someone is crowding his space, he's a head taller than whoever is guarding him. So when he swings his elbows around, they're pretty much going to be head high, whoever's guarding him. So I'm wondering what he's supposed to do. How are you guys going to prevent that? More offensive fouls being called.
Well, he can swing them higher and miss the guy's face. I think is one correction that can be made. You know, what he's doing is, you know, he's stepping off to create space, and you know, it's unlucky that it happened twice the way it did. I think he made both shots. But it's just an adjustment that needs to be made. It's a unique play. Look, there aren't, you don't see any other 7'3" guys, you know, making that kind of a footwork play that has his kind of skill. And so, you know, he'll adjust, and we'll make, you know, we'll do our best to make sure that it doesn't happen again. But you know, I can never say anything definitely for sure, you know, especially when you're talking about NBA basketball.
Eddie?
Rick, I know you got your own issues to take care of, but I'm was wondering what you thought of the NCAA tournament so far, especially with all these upsets, and you know how it is for players and coaches in that, when you're in that situation.
Yeah, I watched some of it. I watched a little bit last night, and up to that point, there had not been many, if any, upsets. And then I guess all hell broke loose, you know, later last night and today. And so, yeah, that's what the NCAA tournament's all about. It's, you know, you're talking about a one and done tournament, high pressure, you know, chance of a lifetime. You know, that it's not like playing a series. You know, it's not even like playing a three-game series, which the NBA used to do way back when. You know, the one and done in a 40-minute game is, you know, that's as pressurized as it gets. But it creates an amazing amount of excitement, enthusiasm. You know, the game I watched some of last night was the Gonzaga game, and you know, you get so fixated on the NBA season. You know, I wasn't aware that they're having the season that they're having. They're 27-0, and I mean, have won every game by, except for one or something, by 10 points or more. I mean, you know, the watching them play is, you know, they're a machine. And so, but you know, last day or so, really, we've spent a lot of time preparing for the second game here in Portland, but you know, March Madness is something else. I was fortunate to be part of it for a couple years in the mid '80s, and you know, we had a Cinderella team that got on a roll, and you know, when you get something like that going, there's nothing like it.